So here we go. Episode 119, July 21, 1991. Those fateful days of yesteryear. The Vince McMahon press conference. This. What's. Who? What?
Well, how did it go down?
Yeah. This is my official reaction after hearing this again after all these years. This was a. John, you pick up the ball. I'll say something very bad. You just pick it up.
Well, here. I mean, it was not a pleasant situation. I mean, for me, when I was informed that they were going to have a press conference at the Plaza Hotel in New York City to talk about the steroid scandal, the Zaharian situation, them implementing their steroid policy, official steroid policy, I called and asked for credentials. I was told there was no press conference, and it just kind of shocked me. I started calling around to other journalists, and you know, guys like Meltzer knew about it, but I was, you know, I was told there wasn't anything, and then I had to call up and get into this thing under an assumed name. I mean, I had to use the name of Chris Frome from the station I was broadcasting from at the time.
Wow.
I was like, I'm the news director here, and Chris was the PD for WGBB, WBABAM, just around the time they were switching their call letters. And that's how I was able to get the information and get into that press conference to cover it. And then once I got there, you know, I mean, there it was filled with reporters, but most of them didn't have a clue about what was going on, and they were going to believe anything that they were told. For the most part, a few hard questions were asked, and I think I led off the press conference with a hard hitting question as Chris Frome from WGBB, and I asked probably three or four questions in this press conference to Vince, and then we had a little exchange at the end of it, actually.
Yes.
So it was for me, and it was kind of like, all right, you know, I have to ask these questions, and I'm glad I'm here. I wasn't well received by Steve Planamenta, who was the PR person, and what Vince McMahon knew or did not know about wrestling journalists being excluded from this, only he knows. You know, after that press conference, when I followed him with the other reporters asking some questions, that's when the real shit hit the fan.
Yes, absolutely. And I in my notes here after reviewing this show after so many years, I wrote, this is the unhappiest pro wrestling spotlight ever aired. And I laugh as I say this, but I really meant it. This, you were not in a good mood on this particular episode, and I can see why, because what you had to go through to cover a legitimate news event,
yeah,
was, we'll talk more about that. Why don't we just play the opening, because this is one of the all-time great PWS openings of all time. Shall we do that?
Yeah, let's do it.
I personally experimented with decadurabolin for a very short period of time. Decadurabolin is an anabolic steroid. It was applied to me by a Dr. Savorian. WWF does not push wrestlers in terms of size. We have nothing to hide. Our wrestlers have always been accessible to the media through normal channels. First of all, I'm not aware of what Hulk Hogan is going to say tonight, sir. And if I were, I'd be very happy to share it with you. I did not make Hulk Hogan a millionaire. We take wrestlers from all walks of life. It is extremely important from a business standpoint to do that, because not everyone would want to look at a very muscular individual. It gets very boring.
Vince, can I just ask one question, please? Why was the professional wrestling media denied access to this press conference today?
I wasn't aware that...
I can answer that, and they weren't. None of them called.
The following program furnished by John Arezzi. You're listening to the new WGBB. The phone lines are open at 955-1240. Now, it's time for the Pro Wrestling Spotlight on the new WGBB.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to another edition of the Pro Wrestling Spotlight right here on 1240, Long Island's first radio station, WGBB. Well, it was another big week in the world of professional wrestling. As most of you know, Vincent K. McMahon held a press conference at the Plaza Hotel in New York City on Tuesday in the luxurious Terrace Room, the same room where Donald Trump and Mrs. Trump announced their divorce. And it was a very, very plush affair. There was nice coffee and donuts and all kinds of little things for the media to snack on before they were fed a lot of information from Mr. McMahon. Unfortunately, the wrestling media, per se, was not really told about what was going on. The wrestling media was not invited to this press conference. The only way that yours truly got in was to use a alias, and that was of Chris Frone here at WGBB, our program director, and we'll explain everything as far as how we got in, and we also had a bit of a confrontation with the WWF after the press conference, because I really wanted to know why wrestling media was not allowed or not invited to this particular press conference. Vince McMahon admitted on Tuesday that for a short period of time he had experimented with Decadorobalin, which is an anabolic steroid. He also talked about his new steroid testing policy in the WWF. There was a lot of media there, AP, the Daily News, the New York Post, the New York Times, Entertainment Tonight, ESPN, a number of other different media people, including Variety. It was about a 30-minute press conference, question and answer session. We were fortunately able to get in about four of our questions before the press conference ended. We will have the entire press conference here for you today, exclusively on a Pro Wrestling Spotlight. We're going to be joined at approximately 10:45 by Mr. Alex Marvez of the Miami Herald, who also had been calling for information regarding this press conference, but of course, his calls were never returned. It's just a very, very interesting way, the way they operate and do things over there in Connecticut.
Yeah, that was a pretty cool open, I would think. Worked hard on that one.
It paid off. It really summed up the mood right there.
Yeah, I edited the clips, and I just felt that using that funeral for a friend theme in the back of it was really cool to use as well.
Yep. Really sum things up well.